This is a regularly scheduled meeting of the Sunderland Board of Selectmen. If we could call to order, we're a little bit late because, frankly, we were just being social. 6:36, please. First up tonight, we're going to talk with Chris Collins from FCAT about town office space availability. There's a studio in Deerfield that's currently rented by FCAT for some time now. And we had initiated a conversation collectively 2 years ago, and it sounds like it's being resurrected. We're going to talk about minutes, we're going to go through selectmen's updates, and then we're going to circle back around to warrants. We have a part of the extension of last week's homework was, what was parcel A and B on School Street, and what is the land transfer, and we've got more information and detail about that. And our goal tonight is to move through as much of the warrant as possible. We've scheduled a meeting for the 19th, next Tuesday, to close that up so it can be out. And an update from about the town report, almost all the submissions are in place, it's being collated. And I had a thank you to everybody from our office today. They're working on it. Expect it electronically this week. Thanks so much. Okay, so first up, any comments on the board? Tommy had great pictures downstairs, old pictures.
I had the opportunity to meet with Sophie Bashinsky's daughter, Janet, the other day. And she's donated some, I'll call them artifacts, treasured possessions, pictures of School Street. I don't know if it's School Street. It's probably Bridge Street back then. Bob, what they call that back then when you were a kid? That's before 1938. It could be Bridge Street back then, but it's actually just before the bridge during the hurricane of 38, just before we lost the bridge, and it looks down the road, and there's a couple, there's a boat being pulled away, and so you can see some of the still houses that were there, see where the bridge was during that period of time. Also, it was very interesting. There's an invitation. It was in 1947. The town of Sunderland had a welcome back celebration for all its men and women. Note I did say women. That served in the Second World War, and it was held in 1947, and it was. And they list all the returning, and also, unfortunately, list the three members of our community that did not return as well. So there's a bunch of history. And Janet, Bob may remember this, and Janet talked about, she said there was they always took stuff out to the back, and it was a door in the back. They used to lift a door, and they used to put all their stuff in the back.
Of a house? Or?
No, like a hatch.
Okay,
a hatch.
Yeah.
And she doesn't remember what was in it, but I was talking to an old-timer today, and I was kind of mentioning the story. He thinks back in the war, there was an effort to, they were always trying to recycle everything, and he remembers, and Chris could ask some people up in Greenfield, because I still think they're going to find houses in Greenfield, it was for the pigmen.
Oh.
People would put all their garbage that could be used, you know, the edible stuff for pigs, and they would fill like a compost, but people would come around, and the guy said he could remember people at this individual at 3 o'clock in the morning coming, lifting up the thing, picking up the bucket, and so I'm thinking, I'm going to talk to Jan, but I'm going to say maybe it was the compost or the food for the pigs. It was just amazing because I was talking to her on Friday. So I don't know. So sometimes we lose so much history, and to me, it's amazing what people used to do with so much less than what we have today. Yep. Less technology. I think it was something to do with hard work. They weren't afraid of hard work back then. But I just think it's very, very interesting stuff.
That's a good way to put it. David, anything you want to add?
No, I think I'm good right now.
Oh, okay. Just general comments of the board?
General.
Oh. Well, we did have our personnel committee meeting.
Oh, nice.
And we're still going over some things, but we did meet with the library staff. And we're trying to get, as we noticed, we have kind of sunk down to the rock bottom of all of our peer groups.
Mm-hmm.
And like in the non-union position. So we're going to try to at least get ourselves up into a competitive stance in there.
Okay.
So we're going to look at that. So,
perfect. First up tonight, Chris is in from FCAT, again, to resurrect the conversation here about town office space. Of course, you know, we utilize the space, not necessarily as effectively as we could or densely as we could, and there's been a conversation with FCAT about what kind of space requirements could they do they need, and could the town of Sunderland be helpful. So, Chris, what are you thinking?
Well, I'm here with Tom Zimnowski.
And Tom.
From the board of directors, vice president, vice chair of the board of directors.
Nice.
And I'm here at the behest of the board of directors to discuss the possibility of FCAT relocating to this building. As you know, for the past, well, as long as I've been director now, and this has been since July, we've been looking for a new home base. Mm-hmm. We have looked high and low, and we have found options that are possibilities, but out of our price range. The latest thing we've been talking about is possibly moving into the second floor of the building that now houses the South County Senior Center. It looks like that's going to be a long-term project if it happens at all. Now, depending on who you talk to, it's 1 year away, it's 3 years away. My feeling is we need to find a place. And as much as we love Leo and as good as he's been to us, and as affordable as that space is, the current facility we're at on 8B Elm Street in South Deerfield is just not conducive to a professional broadcast television environment. So, we came by after, in fact, that the day we toured the senior center, we came by here, Tom and I and Bob, the board chair, and we looked at this space again. And this area over here, you got a big room that could be a studio. I mean, it's one of those things that we've always sort of thought about, but now we're taking a second look at it, because even if we're only here for a couple of years, while this senior center thing percolates or doesn't percolate, I still think we have accessibility issues in that building. Mm-hmm. Nobody in a wheelchair can go into the building, which is a problem. Space is a problem. It's very cramped. There's no storage. It's just a lot of stuff crammed into a small space that, frankly, doesn't work for us. This area, well, I mean, first of all, this building is accessible. There's heat, which is a really
it's always a
thing.
Plus.
It's always a plus. It's, you know, thank God it was an easy winter because it gets cold back there.
Yeah.
And it's pretty spread out. You know, we'd have room for editing bays, and we'd have room for a big studio, and we'd have room for office space, which we have none of that now. Okay. So the board felt, and I agree, that we would like to once again revisit the possibility. Mm-hmm. Moving our operation over here.
Okay.
I'm not sure what that entails in terms of whether I speak with Sherry or we just wanted to get the board's
sure.
thought on this.
Yeah, there was a reach out 2 years ago or 2.5 years ago now, initially, about this first round of search and did it make sense and what was applicable and what was usable space. And you're right in discussing essentially the three rooms that are not this one. One of them, and it was a question that I had, we're wired to broadcast out from this space.
Yep.
You know, that's pretty straightforward. And I think Margaret had worked on area and square feet and a percentage of utilities and basically, you know, in lieu of rent and the hard and fast reality of it. And I'm wondering if that could be dusted off, right? Mm. And then expand it, because I think there's one more area of office space you're talking about currently.
One of the advantages, by the way, of coming over here, I felt was, and one of the selling points for me, was the library. Mm. We've done some work with them. Yeah. I can envision us doing shows over there. It's a beautiful space. We have a great working relationship with the librarian. We just wrote a letter of support for their effort to get a grant to improve the technology over there. Yeah. So I can see a real symbiotic relationship with that organization and a way to open us up even more. The Sunderland community. And I just think that, you know, we need room to grow. The only concern I have is moving across the river is it makes it tougher to connect with Frontier. Mm-hmm. But those connections are going to be there one way or the other. We've got a good guy over there in Kevin Murphy. I think it's time to start getting serious about this. And this right now is our best alternative.
Okay. Questions or comments of the board?
I imagine we can work out like off hours, you know, mm-hmm. things like that. But I mean, otherwise, yeah, I think it's fine because I wasn't supportive of it the last time we were looking at it. And it makes sense to utilize the space we've got. Mm-hmm. I think it's a good thing. And kind of like we were saying about the library too, given the way libraries are used, in a lot of ways, it's more of a community center than what you think of, you know, the old-fashioned idea of what a library was. So it's kind of changing and adapting. So it'd be good.
What I love about that building is that it gets so much space over there, and it's like a natural set for a TV show.
Yeah.
I could see, you know, doing my interviews rather than doing them in the studio, doing them over there and bring people in, and we could, you know, there's all kinds of ways to go with that.
Nice. Tom, what do you think?
As long as they don't want to interview me, that's fine.
Yeah, you refuse to come on my show. I've been begging you. You were the first guy I asked.
For a lot of good reasons. For a lot of good reasons.
Spotlight on the air. I asked Tom Feidenkevitz first.
Yeah. He asks you a question, before you know what you're doing, you're making a fool out of yourself. Not that that ever happened before in this meeting. I thought it was my only concern is, I think, even when we first started out, the connection to Frontier's always been important. Chris has reiterated that he understands that. I'm sure the board of directors understands that. So that has to be something that has to be worked out. I'm sure it will be. I don't know what you need for space right now. I do know that we do have another room over there that's not next door to us. That's not regularly used. At time it's used, but it's very, you know. So I would look at, you know, if you don't have enough room, you know, you could look at that room, the Boy Scout room. You can look at that also. Mm-hmm. I'm not really too concerned about rent. I would just say that if you want, you know, cover your expenses, you know, your utilities, your heat, your light, and if you want different access into the building, and that can be arranged very easily. I mean, it's very easy to have two sets of locks on the doors, mm-hmm. To gain access. I don't have any problem with any of that stuff. I think FCAT is doing above, beyond what our original thoughts were for that. So, and my guess it would be a temporary, you know, couple, 2-3 years maybe. Yeah. And
who knows? If we like what we have, we may just stay. I mean, if it's all right with you guys,
it works.
I don't know what's going to happen with the senior center. I mean, it's a nice idea. But I've been in that building, and my God, it's going to take a lot of work. Mm-hmm. And I just don't want to be hanging around in a holding pattern waiting for whatever's going to happen there to happen. I want to make a move.
Absolutely. And I can understand it. And again, if you know, you come over here, you make some improvements to the building, and when you leave, those improvements stay. So I don't – and if you're not hurting our feeling, if you go back over to the – and that building, that American Legion building, and again, I always think it should be close to the high school, so
I understand that. So, well, I appreciate that.
It doesn't have to be in Sunderland or any particular town.
As long as it's in the viewer area.
As long as it's nice to make TV.
That's exactly right.
Tom Z, what do you think?
Well, since I've been on the board and started looking at things, it was to take and instead of start visualizing and thinking about things and guessing, to go out and start looking. And that one piece of property, you know, we spent a little bit of money into getting the appraisal done, to get the facts and figures so that we could start comparing apples to apples. And reality set in very quickly when the facts and figures were coming through. But I think that also kind of brought us to the attention that, okay, yes, we need a space. Yes, this is, you know, it's minimal at the best up in South Deerfield, you know. So we start looking around and start putting figures out there and seeing what our budget's going to be like. So this is a good alternative that we brought up. I think the discussion started about 2-3 years ago on this location. And times have changed with Chris's leadership. It seems like, you know, we're doing more production work, mm-hmm. and we need a studio. And they got a good staff. We've got a good staff up there that are doing things. So, and once again, you know, going to Chris's office, which is the control room, which is the back room, which is the storage area, which is, you know, shared by the editors, and everyone's got headphones on, and
it's not pretty.
You know, there's only security
like
thing.
It's a
little doggy that comes and barks, you know, it's people are here. So any information we bring over to our board of directors meetings, we'll be meeting this Thursday. And but you know, we've got things going on, and just looking around at all the alternatives.
Okay. So effective, like, timeline. We talked about kind of an end, you know, maybe a sunset or a potential sunset, but also the beginning. This isn't, we're not pressed to do this in a week and a half.
No, God, no. Okay. I mean, look, we can, if we can get everything negotiated, you know, I'm figuring we could be in here by summer or okay. fall. I mean, it's not as though it has to happen right now.
Okay.
You know, it's one of those things where we can get it done mm-hmm. as quickly as we can get it done. We get it done. If the board's good with it, you're good with it, mm-hmm. and we can negotiate a deal.
Okay.
You know, we could move on this relatively quickly.
Okay. So why don't we do this, if it's a prerogative of the board, have FCAT reps work with the town office, the town administrator, and define the total space and kind of the use of the space. There was originally a document about kind of a one or two rooms, see what the big picture is, and then we can assess its actual impact on the current use of the space. Some of it's a very limited use. Others are, maybe we may need to do some considering of consolidation. So
sure.
that impact we'll have to weigh out, and then from there, we'll begin that exchange. Use
Great.
A very similar formula about, you know, utilities, cover your costs, and go forward from there.
Great, I appreciate it. I look forward to having those conversations. I think we can get something done. And it'd just be nice to be in a building that's fully accessible with heat and where we can make good TV.
Perfect. Any other questions or comments about the FCAT?
No, good Great. Luck. I hope it works out.
As do I.
Thank you.
Thanks very much.
Appreciate it.
Thanks a lot.
Just wanted to get better.
Yeah.
Ready. You're coming on the show sometime.
Yeah.
Okay, if we could, a review of the minutes, and then we'll plow into one other piece of appointment work, and then we'll get into the warrant.
Motion.
Second.
We have a motion to accept the minutes. These are minutes of April 4th. All those in favor?
Aye.
3-0. Okay, we have an appointment here. There was one piece of... at large, under new business here, Capital Improvement Planning Committee. There is interest by community member Rock Warner about being appointed for that. I'm wondering if there's any objections or discussion.
No.
There's not. Motion to approve and appoint.
Motion.
Second.
Motion's made and seconded. All those in favor?
Aye.
Okay. 3-0. And again, that appointment schedule will come back up here when we get into the big list at the end of our normal business here.
This one's a lifetime appointment, right?
That's what I thought.
Damn. Okay. Quickly, if we could, board updates, and then we'll plow through the administrator and then into the warrant. We had first Capital Planning Committee meeting last week. We had two pieces of homework that were leaving. One had to do with a lease arrangement on dump truck. One also had to do with engineering studies for North Main Street reconstruction. What percentage do we have to get at? What's the process around there? Those pieces of homework are still in progress. George is searching out lease arrangements. And then there is a question on to the Regional Council of Governments about this 25, 50, 75% contribution of the state on engineering. Is it date sensitive? Does it knock us out of the tip? And that information, we plan on meeting again either Thursday or next Tuesday. I forget one of the two dates when those homeworks are complete, so we can present a full capital budget. And that's all that I have. David, you said personnel committee met?
Personnel committee, and then I forgot there's one other thing. Beth Greenblatt, our solar consultant, and Sherry also sent in letters to Eversource. Still waiting for a reply back on setting up a call.
Those just cleared Friday night. There was emergency legislation.
The legislation did,
yeah. SREX did, yeah.
Right.
The SREX, yeah.
So that side of it looks good for us now. And it did mention in there that if... they could grant waivers if, for instance, your utility is slowing you up. So maybe we ought to get in line for our waivers now.
I think it's important that the town, if I could just piggyback, David, the town's not looking to utilize the SREX at all. The town's looking to be effectively generate as much power as we consume annually.
Exactly.
And we're looking to be the kind of net zero. That's the model. The developer uses those SRECs as part of the actual PPA and the buyback.
Right, and in their whole financing, making it viable for them as a firm.
Good point. Tom, anything before we plow into the warrant?
Oh, absolutely. The Baker Polito Administration awards $31,300 in housing grants to Beverly in the town of Sunderland. So This is a PATH, and PATH is an acronym for Planning Assistance Towards Housing. There's 14 communities since 2014 that have received the award of money, and Sunderland is one of them, and that will help develop our RFP and design to get that out for 120 North Main Street. So that is outstanding. And for anyone that has ever thought that having a town administrator is not a good thing, this is why you have a town administrator. Sherry, thank you very much. And it was through Sherry's hard work that's how we got that we got this grant, that we even know about those grants. So Sherry, thank you very much. It's a critical thing, and I guess if you went through, and it's hard sometimes because a lot of these grants they come and go so quick because we get work done that you don't even know it, and this is one of them. It's kind of like we need to step back sometime and make a list of all the grants that we get, or not say all, but lists of the grants that we do get, so people can see how we're making money, grant money work for us, and how it's paying that town administrator salary, like we said 20 years ago. So
almost 20.
So Sherry, thank you very much. That's a huge thing. It's a huge thing. And to understand that we're in the same neighborhoods as towns like Beverly, and that's who are so much bigger than we are, and to be able to compete with towns like that, that's outstanding, truly outstanding. Also, it appears that one of the concerns at South County EMS, coming from the Deerfield Finance Committee, was the budgets and how they're made up and such. And the town has been in contact with the Franklin Regional Council of Governments, and we're going to ask them to see if they can develop a grant proposal to compare the expenses that were originally put forward in the budget that was originally put forward in the Baxter plan to today, and see how it's working, and if that has to be modified or changed. So it'll give us a little bit of help better explaining our budgets and how we carry about the budget. So that's something that Sherry's going to start working on with Linda Dunleavy and Phoebe at the Regional Council of Governments. So I don't know, it was just good stuff.
It was a good week, yeah.
I think so. I think, you know, that kind of information is good information. Sometimes we don't get it out there enough. There was another meeting of the 300th celebration committee. It was kind of funny. I work with a guy at the university, and we're talking about stuff, and I was mentioning, oh yeah, you're going to take, you want to participate in the Sunderland's 300th celebration. And he looked at me and he said, 300th? Sunderland's 300 years old? That means it's older than the United States. I go, exactly, we are. We are older than the United States of America. We were founded before the Revolutionary War. So,
you know, 66 years.
Yeah, and he lived in this town for a few years, and he never realized that.
Never
put it together. Yeah. So I thought that was kind of good. So there was another meeting of the 300th, and I would say if anybody's interested in the 300th and you have ideas, or they'd like to do something, or if you have a good idea for the committee or something that you want to head up, then there's usually one meeting a month, and come on down to the 300th committee and put your name in the hat, and we'll see what we can do with you.
That sounds perfect. Tom, I think that I appreciate the update. I had written down there about the design development piece on 120. I thought that was just not just yeoman's work, but the recognition of that work by the awarding was good stuff. Okay. Next up, we have warrants and motions. We are whacking away at the annual town meeting warrant. We had homework leaving last week. We had legal staff, and we asked for support from the initiators of said discussion. And so here they are. Come on up.
representing the Pathways Committee from the great state of North Carolina is...
I would say North Carolina, Scott.
Well, okay. Virginia, or how about... Illinois. There you go. I actually like Illinois. I'm going to go there in a few weeks. So we have a pair of parcels that we were talking about last week. And Marina, I don't know if it makes sense for us to find a way to...
We could put the little one on this.
On the document scanner? Is that... No?
She doesn't like that thing.
You don't like that thing?
We can hold it up like this and do it
like a selfie.
How close can you get?
Or I could get it like...
Yeah, exactly like that. So there's two warrant articles here at play. There was actually an alternate warrant article as of last week's draft that has been removed by advice of town council. When I came into this office this afternoon, Jerry said, well, we got guidance from Copeland and Page, and here it is. And I looked and I said, oh, it's all the stuff in red, right? Exactly. Zip, 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 zip. Rock's actually got one on his lap. Exactly right, the draft. And so it simplifies in some ways the actions a town can take. However, timing as such they are, town meeting as such as it is, it was important to bring forward the discussion about what is the infamous triangle parcel and what is parcel A, B, land swap, alternate, etc. And we've cleared up some of it. So first of all, thanks for coming in. We know that there's been work going on to secure this unnamed, unused parcel here, affectionately known as the triangle, and we think we're pretty clear about that. But if you wouldn't mind, maybe triangle 101.
Okay, maybe I'll let Nancy do it. She's sure. Been leading the
triangle charge.
Yeah.
The triangle is very simple. It's a weird triangular shaped piece of property left over from the various bridge replacements over the years. It was presumed owned by the town. However, when we looked into formalizing renovation of the access road down to the river for people who boat, it turned out that in fact it was not officially owned by the town. So when the town takes action at town meeting to obtain it, that means then we will officially own the triangle, and then the state Fish and Game Department has promised, in writing even, that they're going to come in and pave that access road and then build a proper little boat ramp out of cement that will allow access into the water for small boats. And so it's kind of a housekeeping measure to officially put our stamp on.
Actually, really put the pin where on all three corners. And people who are hoping to broadcast here soon, the triangle effectively starts essentially at, you know, the Granite Highway boundary and goes kind of, well, will be, you know, west, northwest toward the river and then chases along an existing boundary. And essentially it's the gravel road access and some area around the gravel road access and not much else.
Well, it pretty much goes up against the bridge abutment. Yeah, exactly. Pretty close to the bridge abutment over to the hill in front of the Ahern property, right, or formerly the Ahern property.
Right. So it, at its widest, 73-ish feet. At its narrowest, a pin. So, again, that one there seemed to be pretty straightforward. And the Pathways Committee had worked on that, again, and we have some CPA funds associated with that and a little bit of notification. Legal funds have been expended, notification to potential heirs, and it goes on the Wayback Machine. Tom's photo earlier tonight happened to...
Oh, you didn't see that, did you?
Happened to have...
I have a picture of the bridge just before it got wiped out.
So it's kind of interesting to actually see that, this perspective, when it was actually the street. And the bridge was there. And there's you know, people getting out of a canoe, and that's different. The water shouldn't be that high, but it makes for good drama. Anyway, that said... Tonight's discussion was that, and thank you for the synopsis. That's pretty straightforward. There's a reserve fund that's set aside.
There it is.
Go, Techie. Thank you so much. So as we look at the triangle piece, that part is relatively straightforward. And
Trade Point.
Parcel A.
Yeah, parcel A, and actually...
There's no A mark on it.
Yeah.
Now, but you can, there's no A mark, and we can just draw the triangle
just
out.
Point to
oh,
it.
I see.
Yep.
There's the triangle.
Parcel here.
Yep. Right. Goes straight up, and it comes right back down.
That's the river.
Wow, looks like you did that in the other life. Sarah.
People weren't guessing letters or nothing. So anyway, so it's effectively that parcel is something that we have done title research on, history on, are looking to establish as a town piece of property, with the overall goal being guaranteed access and access improvements from via the gravel road to a proposed river accessway. That said. Parcel, any questions about parcel A? Pretty straightforward.
One.
Sure, Rob, go ahead.
What survey map date are you referring to in the article?
And that's a good question.
I think it's
February 16th.
I want to make sure that that's...
Because there's a March plan, which may be...
February 16th, 2015?
Is that the March?
Well, you're going to want... You're going to want the surveyor's bounds, meets and bounds.
But this is the most...
Yeah.
I think
this is February 16th, too.
Yeah.
Oh, that March.
Okay.
March 15th.
Yeah, so you're right. I see here under existing conditions, the date, Rock, you're absolutely right. It does say 2/16/2015, and we'd have to just title it accordingly to this one.
Yeah, it's the A&R plan for the planning board, I guess.
Okay.
Because it says approval not required. Okay. Plan of land in the town of Sunderland, blah, 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 March 15th, 2016.
Okay.
And that refers to parcel B also, because the same plan shows parcel B.
Okay.
So if that has a February date, then that should be changed to March 15th, 2016.
Okay.
Yeah, it does.
And can you say as amended, because Randy might have to do an amendment to this plan.
Okay.
Or is that not
on the triangle piece, or are on A rock?
On
B
article K, I think. Mm-hmm. You might have to do something.
Okay. So if you go through the detail on the warrant, we can work with the office about the actual language.
Okay.
Make sure it passes muster with Copeland and Page. So the A looks like it's relatively straightforward. The B, as you see, there was a draft warrant.
Just go back to A.
Mm-hmm.
To me, I would assume that we're going to be putting in the meets and bounds just like we do on a regular deed. Mm-hmm. You're going to have the locations of the pens. You're going to give your runs along each axis, and that's
in the warrant article.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay.
Really? I think you should have the meets and bounds, and then and right. I mean,
you can't just refer to the surveyor's plan, yeah. Tom. You have concern about that?
Reference plan.
I would put in the article that's published. I would put the meets and bounds. The motion. I would say that it's reference a plan. You can reference a plan at that point. But in this, I would put down. It's a legal document, so you would want. I think you would want to know where your pen locations are, and that way someone could always pull out the warrant from in 2015 or 2015.
Yeah, well, that's last year.
In 2115, someone could pull out the warrant and know exactly where that parcel is located. I don't know. I would just feel much more comfortable if we had the exact. For the warrant on the warrant, we just list the exact.
It's one more historic document.
Yeah, that?
Might have a time constraint getting that done. You know, you'd have to go out and put the pins.
Yeah.
We need to sign the warrant on Tuesday so that it can be posted by Friday.
Does he
7
have it?
Days
Does,
before the town meeting.
He should. He.
Survey.
We should.
It's already
should,
done.
It's already done.
Yeah, we're just putting in the wording.
Yeah, you're just putting the words.
Remember that the deeds back and forth could have the meets and bounds in there.
No, I mean, we can always fall back on a plan, mm-hmm. but I mean, I would think the goal would be to to have it defined.
Okay, I think that makes good sense if we get some definition on
that. I think.
Are the pins going to be set?
Randy has not been asked to set the pins for the triangle.
Okay. I don't think that there's no need to have the pins set right now. At some point when we take ownership, we'd probably set pins, but right now there's no.
So the meets and bounds give us a more firm description in a legal document that the town's actually going to vote on.
Right.
And that's something that would be a goal.
Right.
Okay. Any questions or concerns about that?
Can't see that it does any harm.
Okay.
You know, just adds a little more.
The surveyor should be able to clock it right out via existing data. Okay.
Well, it's already defined.
Right.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, exactly.
Should be, yeah.
Okay.
Is the information?
Exactly.
Yeah. I mean, if I look, you got the plan there, Scotty?
Yeah.
Isn't it defined? You got survey marks on it?
Yeah.
Is that the old one?
Yeah. This is the February one.
February. Let's see. Oh, yeah.
They should give you your runs and headings.
Yeah, it's shortened up, it looks like, but that's about the extent of it.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, we can put that in the form of a question out to the office of Harold Eaton and see if it can give us some language. Okay, easily done. So a discussion about A, we moved to B. That was the one that had my head spinning last week. I'm like, wait a minute, what is this? Is it, you know, just all knotweed and bittersweet? What are we doing here? We're trading a porch for knotweed? Anyway, people on the riverbank know that joke. With respect to B, there was an alternate, and that alternate was withdrawn, one of the two. And maybe, Sherry, you can give me the synopsis, give us all the synopsis on that parcel. On that language that council decided no.
Right.
Too complicated.
She has deleted the M and replaced it with N. Which will, to see if the town will vote to authorize the Board of Selectmen to acquire by gift, purchase, and or eminent domain the access, utility, and or recreation purposes the parcel of land shown as parcel B on a plan of land entitled Existing Conditions Plan of Land, Sunderland, Mass. Prepared by, we're going to have to change that date, mm-hmm. Harold Eaton.
Yep.
A copy of which is on file with the town clerk. And any and all drainage, utility, and other easements related thereto. And as funding for such acquisition and costs related thereto, to raise and appropriate or transfer from available funds or any combination thereof a sum of money. And so that one, she says, that's the one that we would need to refer to the planning board. No.
Have you guys seen the email thread from Sharon today?
Okay. Parcel B, as you know, we originally intended to lay out Parcel B as a public way, but we do not have time to undertake the layout process, including planning board recommendations, two meetings of the Board of Selectmen, and other steps. Instead, I have provided an alternative article which authorizes the selectmen to acquire the property simply for access, utility, and or recreational purposes. You may change the purpose of the acquisition if you would like, but I recommend that there be at least one public purpose, say recreation. The town may lay out Parcel B at a later time.
So am I hearing that that's council's authorization to negotiate with a defined parcel B, and then there's a subsequent vote?
Right, planning board, and two meetings of the Board of Selectmen.
Okay, so with respect to parcel B, mm-hmm. current status, there is a land swap that was part of the original concept. And how are we doing with that?
I'm not fancy. I'm on the spot.
Okay. You drive a hard bargain.
So, the concept of the land swap here.
I'm going to capture it right there, right?
The current owners of the green parcel
yep.
have a porch that is encroaching on town land.
Okay.
So, it's in their interest mm-hmm. to obtain from the town that green rectangle so that they can have their porch and a little bit of land in front of their house and own that. And it, in exchange for that, the idea is that the town will then obtain the blue parcel, which is not just knotweed, but in fact very useful because we can have a sort of modest natural material path there. And then once the boat ramp is installed and the boat access road is paved, then you can have a sort of very nice little connector from the path that goes down to the river and then along the river to where the town-owned land begins at the edge of the ball fields.
Oh, nice.
And then you could have kind of a loop trail, you know? Mm-hmm. So that's the concept.
Okay.
The owners of the green, well, no, the owners of the blue parcel are on board with swapping that for the green parcel, but they feel that there's a differential in terms of how much the properties are worth. So we've had an appraisal done, and they want to do their own appraisal before they go forward, but they have given every indication that they are very much in favor of this going through.
Okay. Okay, parcel B update, continue.
And I just want to say that the funding for us to pay the difference is part of the CPA, which is, I don't know which article it is. It's a couple past. A
couple articles
there.
down.
So there's there will likely be the funding in place to cover the expense of the differential
through the Pathways Committee.
Okay. Discussion. Rock, go ahead.
There's one wrinkle on parcel B. Do you see on that plan over there that March 15th?
Yep.
See the little triangular wedge next to parcel B with a curve on it?
Yep.
There's some question as to whether that's included in parcel B or not.
Okay.
So Dan and I were talking and thinking that you might want to call that parcel E.
Okay.
And also take parcel E. So if you're wording for article N where you talk about parcel B, you might want to say parcel B and
E.
A 2B.
Okay. That's so rife with an opportunity.
Exactly.
It's just a softball.
Just 2B.
Okay.
Or 2B.
Let me clarify that the idea of the curve there and in parcel E is... Yeah. That we want to make sure that there's room for there to be steps going from the access road to the new path along the river.
So it would accommodate that.
Yeah.
Okay. So we have effectively a land transaction. We have an owner that is willing in dialogue, that is looking for a second set of eyes in the appraisal. And this new, this potential curve, this sort of like little clipping of the corner of the land swap parcel, is part of a new discussion?
No.
No, part of the discussion.
Right, we're just worried that the warrant needs to explicitly
stay. Got it. Okay, and Tom, that would actually go to your bounds and means and actually defining the space. This is not the discussion, but
I could argue the other way that the green is more valuable than the blue because if the river changes course,
the other way,
we may lose. While a pretty safe bet that green is always going to be there.
Yes, but we have to go with what the appraisers say, so they're going to get a second opinion.
I understand.
Yep. Okay.
So we're wondering if the timing of this, can we move forward with that warrant article if the final agreement isn't signed?
I don't.
Like, is it?
If there's money involved, no. Right. You have to be able to appropriate the money.
But if it's funded by
the Pathways.
Yeah.
By the who?
Pathways Committee through CPA.
Well, it's kind of, it looks kind of how they set it up.
Well, and it's a vote to authorize the Board of Selectmen.
So it's not a purchase, it's a vote to authorize.
Right.
And there's already targeted funding for it, so.
Yeah, it's not a town appropriation.
So it might be nice, then we don't have to put this off to another town meeting.
Yeah, we don't want.
Because we're close, but it's not going to be signed before town meeting without a miracle.
It seems to me that as I look at it, and please weigh in accordingly, the only wrinkle might be on the definition here says parcel B is plan of land entitled existing conditions, plan of land, town of Massachusetts prepared by. So if the curve little corner piece isn't, if the plan's not accurate, when you bring the article forward, right, we're referring to a plan. If the plan is changed, that could be a wrinkle.
Right.
So the warrant article reading is not about actually doing the transaction. It's allowing the board to do a transaction. But it defines the transaction details. And the details here refer to a plan of a certain date. So if there is a new kind of piece that's carved out of it and it's got to be worded in such a way, we would have to capture that.
Well, I also think that we have to go back and say, while we're talking about parcels of land that are in the same area and sometimes contiguous with one another, there's two plans. There's two projects.
Correct. Oh, yeah, two very different articles.
The first project is with a triangle piece, is by purchasing the triangle piece. What we're doing is allowing a boat ramp funded by the DCR to be put in.
Mm-hmm. Correct.
That's a project.
That's one, yep.
Move that away. Mm-hmm. That's a standalone.
Yep.
The second is parcels B and C that are part of the pathways, a pathways committee goal. Mm-hmm. And so if it's not ready, do we need to go right now?
Mm-hmm. You may need parcel B to do the boat ramp. Am I remembering?
Yeah, that's right. There's a little corner. The boat ramp, there's a little corner that we will be acquiring that would really help for the boat ramp. It could be done narrower, but it'd be much better if we had that piece.
So there's a layout of proposed boat ramp that includes impact heading on the north side.
Correct.
Okay.
So you need parcel B to do the boat ramp.
Yeah.
You wouldn't need to swap, though, right?
No.
So you wouldn't need the swap.
So they want to enter into the river going upstream with the boat ramp? Is that what they're talking?
It curves there now.
Well, actually, if you're going upstream right now, you don't really get out of your canoe there because it's kind of muddy. You're more coming down and entering by where the pavement is.
Yeah.
There was a draft boat ramp plan that the town had done 4 or 5 years ago.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
And on that plan, it shows it getting over into parcel B.
Okay.
I recollect that anyways.
So what I'm hearing here is parcel, the second article, dates on article, I'm going to call it 17, because I have one with numbers now, 17, dates are important in referencing the correct document. The rest of it's passed muster, pretty straightforward from town council. With respect to B, under existing conditions, again, dates are important. That variable, or that corner piece may or may not be important, but, you know, it's enough. For a discussion point. The question becomes, if it's for the board to authorize and to acquire, gift, or approve, this essentially opens the gate to continued negotiations.
Right.
That's the way that I'm reading the article.
Me too.
It's not getting a land yet. We're not doing anything, but we're negotiating.
What letter does 17?
You've got my copy, so I'm not sure.
Hang on.
Oh.
That's okay. Like I'd be the one that's after all the red lines. Yeah,
Article N.
N.
Article B.
Oh, thanks. So as I look at 18 Rock, it's going to be N.
18?
Article. What's on this?
Yeah.
The one you have right here. Got one with all the red? Right below the red. Alternative article.
Dan wrote this red.
Okay. So it's that one right here. Right below all the red out.
So 17 and 18 are here for A and B. Where's C's gone?
Oh, there is no C. The alternative was the one that Sharon had removed.
Yeah.
Well, how are you going to gain
So ownership? Parcel B, Article M was deleted and replaced with Article N, Parcel B.
A more inclusive single article as opposed to two articles. Bob?
There's nothing for Article C and D in this. Is that correct?
There is A and B. That's all we have.
Yeah.
Right?
So are you suggesting that we add a parcel E to? Okay. Is it not too late to add parcel E to this?
I would think we would just have to change the...
And to be determined. Parcel E, is that how you wanted to?
So on the map we've got from February, there's an A and a B. That's it. There's no C and...
C, D, or E.
D or E.
And the March 16th, so...
Yeah, this one right there.
We don't have that one that's up now.
You don't have the March 16th?
No.
Is that what's up there now?
That's what's on the board, yeah.
So even there, I see an A upside down, and I see a B.
See the E?
Or that
just not a B that
faces
the river. So we're going to do something that kind of goes like this, right? Stay. Now we're the river, right? The river runs north. Am I seeing that the way it kind of orients?
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Yep.
There you go.
Okay. So I see an A, and I see a B. Those B's listen.
B, I see a D.
Printed on the river, A. B is, the writing is in the river.
C.
Oh.
D.
And this would be the...
E. That would be E. So.
So you wanted to take E also. Just to be sure.
So we would have to note those additional letters in the article.
And this is the way Dan mm-hmm. annotated it.
Got it. Okay, so we got a B, a D, and an E that are part of the swap. You're swapping D for B.
Yes.
You're swapping D for B.
No,
right?
D for C.
C. Yeah.
D for C.
But because...
Oh, B. I'm sorry. Yeah.
They're presumed owned by the town, but for the sake of being absolutely clear for the future, since this was such a muddy mess, it would be better to clarify B and E as well.
Got it.
So we're swapping D for C and including B and E. Is that correct?
Because I'm just thinking how we've gone through all of this. Like, when we get to town meeting, we got to be really, like, you know?
Just explaining.
It's like, well, no, which one was it again? It would almost be nice if we could get a version, at least to project up, that has each one in a different color.
I was going to say.
Yeah.
Who's responsible for
that
the
we project.
Graphics? Is that something
that you... Okay. So the overarching goal here, of course, is A is clarification.
Hand-colored, please.
B is partial acquisition for trade. The homeowner, the owner, property owners, who also all own what looks like, is it C, Bob, or D that runs along the river?
They own...
C is the one along the river.
Okay, yes. They own C.
Right.
Yeah.
We own D,
yep.
B.
And we're looking to swap D for C?
No.
Yes.
And clear up B and E.
Right.
When you're all done.
Yep.
They swap and clear. House, we'll end up with D.
Yep.
The town will have everything else. A, B, C, and E.
Right. Got it.
Right. And School Street will...
And B is cut off.
In front of their house.
Right. School Street actually ends up shorter than it currently is.
That's right.
Yep. Yeah, this one didn't have...
See, you have to define that, too.
Yep.
I was missing...
So that's the...
Put that away, because it just adds noise to it.
I know, it does, right?
It just adds noise.
Continuing a road. Or is it part of a road?
Just continuing part of a road.
Now, is that a town road, or a state road, or a county road?
Oh.
I think the language says discontinuance.
Well, you have, if you're gonna shorten it, then you're gonna have to, you have to define that, you have to define that, and you gotta figure out, is School Street, is that a county road? Town road, or state?
A good question.
Discontinue it.
Well, it's not a state road, because the state would be prominent.
Right, right.
So it's either a county, if it's a county or a town road.
I would think that...
Usually you have to go into, our road book downstairs.
The county abandoned and it went back to the town.
That's what I was gonna say, when we moved over the bridge, right, that's when it came back to the town?
Not necessarily, because the bridge was owned by a corporation within the town of Sunderland.
That's right, it was a private...
Right.
The town of Sunderland. We had very good businessmen in Sunderland.
But it must have been a town road to get there.
Could have been. Could have been a county road. Usually county roads were roads of commerce.
I haven't heard any discussion of it being a county road.
Well, I didn't know you're shortening the road, that's why. I know you're shortening the road, but when you do anything to a road, you have to have hearings to discontinue roads or discontinue portions of roads, et cetera. You have to have public hearings and the whole shooting match. So if you're shortening the road, you're gonna have to do that.
Well, your Article K, I don't know what the number is now, but mm-hmm. first one of the three articles mm-hmm. talks about discontinuance of the road. That's the vote, isn't it? What that article is for, discontinue the road.
Yeah, there is an article prior to these two about discontinuing a portion of School Street, public way, blank line, shown as blank line. Board deems appropriate. To Tom's point earlier about some of the public hearing part and the public survey part, but there is an article, Rock, specifically to answer your question. Yes. Disposition, discontinuance, portion of the land, purposes of sketch and plan. So we have that article included currently.
And we'd have to have a public hearing before?
Well, that was my question, is the timing of the public mm-hmm. hearing. Do we need it before or after?
Oh, no, you always do.
Under
before.
Article K for the land swap, the planning board referral, the board needs to refer it to the planning board in order to discontinue a public way. The selectmen need to refer the discontinuance to the planning board for its non-binding recommendation. I recommend this referral be done as soon as possible, although the planning board would ordinarily have 45 days to make its recommendation. The planning board needs to submit its report prior to town meeting.
Oh, okay, and we're meeting tomorrow.
May recommend or not recommend the discontinuance, but a report must be submitted. A simple vote of the planning board to recommend or not recommend is sufficient.
Oh, okay, great.
You can't, that's, it's not on your agenda. You need 48 hours to talk about it.
Right. Okay, so we'll need to have a schedule another meeting. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Before the end of the month.
So it's planning board action, public input action. Go ahead.
In listening to the conversation,
mm-hmm.
it sounds like there's a lot of, when it came in, I thought it was relatively clear.
A is really simple.
But now it sounds like things are pretty well muddied up.
Mm-hmm.
Question becomes whether or not you
want
to include it on this
form
or a special town meeting or something.
Mm-hmm.
Would it make any sense for us, the committee, to talk to Sherry
mm-hmm.
and go over the exact wording of the name of the plan, the parcels mm-hmm. and whatever, so it wasn't tying up you guys tonight? Does that do anything to move that along?
Well, this warrant, we're ready to close the warrant out here a week from tomorrow. So, you know, there's a week.
Yeah. I mean, the pins are in the grant.
Mm-hmm. Understood. That helps with definition of A and some of the other line of inquiry. The key about, I was going to make a suggestion, I'll circle back to here in just a second.
Boy, I'll tell you what, if you discontinue that road in front of their house, they don't have frontage.
Yes, they do. We figure that out carefully.
Right?
No, the planning board figured it out.
Yeah. Yeah, the surveyor was mm-hmm. very careful about that to make sure there was 120 feet.
And the discontinuance
yep.
there, Can you put some wording in there that says something to the effect that, in parentheses, after the discontinued part, say, all in all state.
Yeah, would have to, absolutely.
Regulations or something like that.
Right.
And that would allow the thing to go through.
Mm-hmm.
And yet.
The actions still have to occur.
Right. And then you're stating that you're following those required actions. Yeah, because it's kind of the same theory about how they wrote up that second article, too.
Okay.
In that, you know.
So it's including the caveat, effectively.
Yeah.
What you really want to do is make sure that, okay, here are the steps to be done after town meeting.
Right.
Right.
And you can list them.
Okay.
Personally, I feel confident that if you lay out the big picture in terms of having this done before the tricentennial, people will be in favor of it.
Yeah, yeah.
And I hate to get tripped up on, you know, what are, in the end, fairly minor considerations.
This is always raise the curtain before show night jitters.
Right.
So it's 3 weeks before the annual town meeting. It's always the same. It doesn't. It's going to be a different issue next year. It's always the same story.
I mean, I feel like the parcels have been laid out by the surveyor. The pins are in the ground.
Yep.
It's very clear what the delineations are. We need to make sure that the language in the warrant is clear.
Yep.
Well, that's what we're getting tripped up because all the parties involved are all in agreement.
Yes.
So it's not like it's something that's going to get out there and be debated on in that respect. Right. It's really just fumbling over the legal procedures
filling in the blanks.
The wording.
It says here the planning board must have 45 days before town meeting in which to comment and report to the selectmen concerning the advisability of discontinuance of the road in question. Mass General Law Chapter 41, Section 81GI.
But they don't have to take the full 45.
Right.
Huh?
Yeah.
They don't have to use the full 45.
No, that's not what it says. It's the planning board must have 45 days before town meeting in which to comment.
Do you have insurance?
Well, if they commented
there, I just gave it to you.
That's okay.
That's still within
that window. Yeah, we get counsel on the other side on the same issue, actually. And again, I think...
as long as it's referred to them before town meeting.
The appropriate steps. If I could circle back to the order here, I'd like to change... What I have right here is 16, so it precedes only the 17. I'm sorry, it precedes only the 18. It seems to me that that's germane mainly to the discontinuance discussion, is only germane to Article B, unless I'm completely wrong. We don't have to do any discontinuance of road with respect to Article A.
No.
Land grab A. So yeah. I'd like to have that be right in front of.
Okay.
So A really is...
separate.
It's a separate decision. It's a relatively easy definition. We can go right through that one, check that box. And then the discontinuance article, because it rocked to your credit, nailed that one earlier. Like, well, there is one, but it preceded the discussion about A. That should be sequential with the discussion about B.
So okay. A is 16 and...
Yeah. Flip 16 and 17.
16. Okay.
I think that makes the most sense. Sorry.
16 and 17.
Yeah, because the discontinuance, Bob, isn't really... anything to do with the Article A.
Right, and by putting it first...
By putting it first, it's like, okay, so why are we discontinuing a road and then having a conversation about a neat, clean land, you know, definition?
Makes sense.
Okay, so it sounds like there's homework here before here on Tuesday, right? We have another meeting. We're already posted for next Tuesday. We're meeting Tuesday because Monday is a legal holiday, and that meeting will be at 6:30. And if the three of you and Sherry can get together and work with Sharin and the folks over at Eaton's office and make sure that it's as Bob says, a little clearer than the current mud. Conceptually, it's good. I completely understand it. It's uh-huh. It's the mac. It's and as Dana Kennan used to say, it's the machinations. It's like, how are we getting, you know, getting it? How do we get the veggies to look like a salad? Okay.
Ducks in a row.
Right.
Okay.
So that it's
okay,
easily
so
explained to somebody who's not involved.
Exactly.
That's the key.
Right.
Yeah.
Rock?
One thing I might suggest is that when Bob does an intro, that he first says these next couple articles are complicated, whatever. But at the end of the day, the town will end up owning A, B, C.
Great
D,
point.
And D will go to the landowner.
Yeah.
And you can have a graphic that very clearly.
Yes. Great way to put it, actually.
And then the votes just become
right.
Matter.
Right. and the language in the warrant article is going to be the important part. Again, adding the E, I think, to Dan's credit.
And the boat ramp is A, the triangle. The objective here is to have a path along the river, a town-owned path along the river.
Perfect. Yeah. Great way to put it.
Wow. according to the law, under Section 32A, the Board of Selectmen may be able to abandon the road.
Oh.
That portion of the road.
We can abandon the road. If it no longer is used or caused confusion since the law does not define it. Of course.
When did laws become confusing?
In other words,
it seems like they're just always so clear.
Unlike the town meeting, Section 32 allows that the Board of Selectmen find that the road in question has become abandoned and unused for ordinary travel, and the common convenience and necessity no longer requires said town way.
There you go.
Right.
So maybe another alternative, if Shireen says we could do it that way.
Yeah.
That would be easier.
Sherry, could you ask her about 32A?
Yeah, she did mention getting a discontinuance plan and have the surveyor mark the discontinued portion.
So that would be what they call out already, just simply moving the boundaries out. And that's in the,
it's all
pinned. Yeah, right.
So Board of Selectmen have to call a public hearing, registered mail to the abutters.
Now we know there's about 26 of those just in the triangle.
Right. Not no more.
Almost. Almost. That was pretty remarkable. Actually, people who may not know the backstory, you know, when you reach out to the heirs and do the title search, it's amazing how that thread just runs. And I was like, what? Anyway, so there's a lot of names there. Interesting. Okay, so there's some homework going forward. We'll wrap it up before next Tuesday.
Awesome.
It sounds like we have a couple of opportunities here, mechanisms. One is through the warrant article process, which is a neater, cleaner way. Town sees everything, they're fully informed and or warned, and then they take action on it. And then another may be for that parcel that is the road discontinuance, the board may have opportunity to take action. But town meeting is still the most effective way, as it is our last remnant of real democracy in America. I'm not kidding.
Not according to the front page of the Boston Globe on Sunday.
No, town meeting still is. Okay. Right, that
thank
said,
you.
Thanks so much for your help. And as well as clarification tonight. I know it's, it kind of went A, B, K, D, E, but, you know, we got there.
Thank you.
Okay. So, Sherry, we'll change this, the article, so the discontinuance is ahead of B. That's pretty straightforward. I went down the article.
There's a few more comments on that draft in blue.
Yep.
Article O.
Yep.
P. We could, and T.
Yep. And are they changed around on the one that we have now that's lettered, Sherry, numbered, updated?
Yep.
So these changes, as I look at this is the most current, updated, and clean warrant. This one here.
Just a few more holes to plug.
Okay. So we've been through, we know 1, 2. We're not going to do 3 and 4 until next week when we finish the budget discussion. I say that because there is
fighting the
finance committee. Yep.
All right.
And capital as well. Capital had 2 pieces of homework, so you're up to 6. Capital stabilization. I wanted to have this discussion tonight about Article 6. We have free cash guidelines. And the free cash guidelines, Tom and David have, as you know, have moved money from free cash to the operating budget, free cash to stabilization, capital stabilization, then free cash to move forward, about a third and a third and a third. Since we have capital stabilization currently funded through levy, does it make sense for us to move an Article 6, the one you have here, does it make sense for us to move that to capital stabilization or split it between stabilization and capital stabilization? Again, some of the restrictions of capital stabilization don't allow us general access. Access is the same, 2/3 by any town meeting, but the definition of capital stabilization fund, you may not be able to get that money out for something that's not capital. Whereas stabilization, the definition is a little broader. Pay a big bill, do something a little different. So I wanted to bring that to the board tonight. It's currently set for capital stabilization. Do you want to split that so it goes some to capital stabilization, some to regular, or all of it to regular stabilization?
I just go regular stabilization.
Because you can always go from regular stabilization for capital.
I would do regular stabilization, and with the understanding that we're looking at buying a fire truck next year.
Yep.
Or it looks like they're going to be asking to buy a fire truck next year. Yep. So I think we should have that option.
Okay. Are we looking at putting some of the OPEB stuff too?
That's all part of the third, actually. Yep. There's okay. 23 right. going in there.
Okay.
Yeah, Tom, that was where my inclination was. I wanted to bring it up for discussion right. with the board. You know, if we then follow the guidelines.
Right.
Yep. Okay.
That makes sense.
So, Sherry, if we could change that, Bob, if you didn't hear that conversation, under article, you have numbers or letters there?
I have numbers yeah. and
okay.
letters.
Okay. So, number six, article six.
Article six.
Yep. That's the moving of available free cash, and the number may change here between now and the motion, to capital stabilization. I want to remove the word capital and just have it go to standard, regular,
old. Stabilization.
So that's article five, actually, because I included one article for regular stabilization, and then article six is for capital stabilization.
Oh, fine. Then let's just out article six.
So
we only need to do one.
Okay.
So article six is amended.
We'll article delete. Six will go away.
Yep.
Okay.
I know, Sherry, that you and I have had a couple of conversations about it, only in that which one does it go
that's
to?
That's why I put both
yeah,
on.
Yeah, exactly. So six will simply go away. And this year, Bob, instead of anything going to capital stabilization, because we raised it on the rate, we'll just put it in regular stabilization. Okay? Thank you. I appreciate that dialogue. You have a capital budget that will be coming. We'll have that number to move forward. That's what's currently 7. 8, we took action. 9, action. 10, action. 11, action. 12's action. 13, 14, 15 all have action. 16, 17, 18 were tonight's discussion. We're going to change the location. We're going to switch 16 and 17. Is there any question about what would be the parcel A outside of bounds definition? Is there any reason we wouldn't recommend it to include tonight?
No.
Okay. Is there a motion to include article referring to parcel A acquisition? It will be future article 16.
Motion.
Right. Yeah. Second.
Okay. Motion is made and seconded. All those in favor?
Aye.
Okay. 17 and 18, that discontinuance and...
So do you want to make a recommendation on 17?
17...
16, right?
Yeah, that's what we just did, Tom. 16, yeah. 16.
I thought that was to include.
Oh, I'm sorry. You're right. It was to include. Motion to recommend. And this, again, is the article 2B16, known as Parcel A.
Motion.
Second.
Motion's made and seconded to recommend. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. 3-0. Thanks, Tom. Good catch. So 17 and 18, which are going to be the discontinuance and the B parcel. Is there enough information for us to recommend to include, or do you want to wait and do them both next week?
16 and 18.
16
right?
and 18 currently.
Next yep. week.
Yeah. Okay. Okay. Easy enough. 19. This is the clarification. It's done. We did this already.
We're just adding the word sum of 18,000.
That's correct.
814.
From sewer reserve. That's all we're doing. That's absolutely right. That's a clarification. It's not an appropriation. It's a clarification of a prior warrant, a prior article.
Sherry? Article 20 has been revised to reflect town council's recommendations.
Okay.
You look on your first draft, Shrin changed the wording on that article.
Oh, I see. So the fund and that last sentence allows for access to the funds in the vein that the trustees were looking to use.
Yeah.
Equip new library or take any vote or relation thereto. Okay.
And then again, so that article was meant to include, and we have a recommendation on that already. Would you just do me a favor and clarify that with Lauren Starr and the trustees, that that makes sense
okay.
to what their goal was?
Yep.
I'm sure Sharin approved it. That makes some sense. And then the consent articles are complete. So really, we get back to next week, we are going to have the B and go ahead, Bob.
Back on 20.
20, yep.
In order to expend fund, I'm assuming that there's some money left over in the building fund that they haven't been able to access?
Correct. That's exactly right. No, you hit the nail right on the head. There was
what would they be doing it otherwise?
Exactly right. And their goal there is to continue to equip the library, and that part of the language didn't allow for, original language didn't allow for what they're looking to do. Okay, thank you. Motions are next Tuesday, and a final warrant is next Tuesday. Okay. No, throw the letter one away. The trap with the plan, too. It's like, yeah. Oh, no. What do you mean you have a new plan?
I always like to keep the latest paper copy.
Yep, good points. Okay, next up for us, we have the aggregate budget. There have been a couple of requests and additions and changes in the course of the current week. David, you mentioned the personnel committee's work. Sherry, there is a request also from Treasurer Collector to add 2 hours to payroll this week?
To the payroll clerk.
Uh-huh.
Correct. To take her from 4 hours a week to 6 hours.
And the net additional expense?
$2,017.
Okay, I see it. And we're going to send this to Finance Committee as well. Need their input. Is discussion of the board, this has to do with some of the additional requirements on the payroll side that have come. Frankly, there's not been enough hours. That's been the chief complaint with respect to getting the work done. When I say getting the work done, I don't mean that in a way that is a comment about the quality of the work or the individual doing the work. It's the volume being budgeted in the course of, you know, that number of hours.
Now with the Affordable Care Act and all that, it just keeps piling up.
Mm-hmm. Right, there's more. And I think also she said that it would help her in training for some other things, mm-hmm. too. So a little more flexibility in the staff, yeah. too, which is
Personnel
nice.
Committee saw that last week?
The
request for
no,
this?
We didn't see that last. No, because okay. that just came up this week.
Okay. Tom, what do you think? I mean, it's late in the game. We're talking about adding hours, but it's also $2,000 worth of adding hours over the course of an entire year.
Well, I would defer to Sherry's mm-hmm. opinion on this. I mean, she's here all the time. So.
Sees it. Yep. Okay. Sherry, any of the changes with respect to this budget that we're seeing here?
No, the only other change is the... Personnel Advisory Committee had recommended salary increases for the library support, so that was an additional $5,706 to that line.
So, David, could you turn back to the first part of the night, had yep. the discussion? This is peer communities?
Yes,
review.
Yep.
Same job descriptions?
Exactly, yeah, to bring them up to... You know, the mid-range, essentially, of those peer-reviewed towns.
Okay. For who's that now?
Which towns are they?
No, what
the
position?
Library support staff.
Right.
Did you compare hours as well, besides just numbers, hourly rates?
We did look at hours. That was one of the discussions.
And how many hours do people get 40 hours a week?
Well, our
operation.
Well, I would say...
I mentioned that topic would come up.
Uh-huh.
I guess I have a concern because we don't set the rates when we hire people.
Mm-hmm.
So if we hire people at arbitrarily low numbers to get them in, and then a couple years later come back to raise their salary, what are we saying?
Mm-hmm.
We're not. So I don't understand how we fall behind, because these positions, some of them are, I don't understand how their positions would fall. I guess I just don't understand how they fall behind. And there's all, and there's other people, there's, we have other town employees that work just as hard that fall behind as well.
Well, that's another point.
So I don't understand why we're just looking at one segment of our town instead of looking at the entire segment.
We're actually not. We're looking at all the segments. We just tackled the library first because we didn't have enough verification the last time. We actually want to tackle.
I disagree with that. I'm going to vote no.
Okay.
I would, again, to me, I would say that those positions were hired. They're not, some of them haven't been long term. I would say I'd have to go back and look at it. I'm sure they've been hired in the last 5 or 6 or 7 years, mm-hmm. some of the positions. Mm-hmm. We didn't set the trustees set those initial rates for a reason. I don't know why now we've had some other people that have been in position a long time that are probably falling way below.
Flat rates, essentially, over years.
Flat rates. It raises, absolutely. So people that have lost hours that haven't regained hours.
Mm-hmm. Well, that was one of the things that we sort of wanted to take a two-step approach from the personnel committee's perspective is, one, make sure that all of, before we tackle bumping up salaries to get into the median, we wanted to make sure that the last of all the hours were restored.
Which, they're not.
Well, I thought Georgia's were the last ones. That was one of the things talked about.
Town clerk.
That's an elected position.
Though. Okay, but that's a position that hasn't been restored. One. I know, yep. and I know positions, I mean, and again, we've been pretty, when you talk about increases in salary and stuff, there's a lot of people in that have worked for the town for a number of years that haven't gotten some of the raises some of the other people have gotten. So if you're, I would just say, if you're thinking about changing anybody, it needs to be done across the board, not, because I would say, well, why are we looking at one group over the other?
Well, we're not. We just.
Well, you are.
No, we're just doing one group first.
Okay.
That sense. We're not looking.
So am I going to give retroactive to the people that you're not looking at this year?
No, we're trying to look at everybody this year as much as we can. We wanted to get them in. We just didn't have the time to do them at the last meeting.
So you're going to change these numbers again then? For this year?
So am I hearing that we're going to have, David, a review? There's twofold. There was a proposal brought forward by the library trustees about some of the defined positions at the library, right? And that's part of the discussion tonight. That one's shown up here. Was the cost of, this is a separate but still the same meeting, was the cost of living increases discussed and recommended and forwarded?
We did, yep, we discussed that, yeah. Right, because that ends up coming up to like 0.8, which okay. We move up to 1%.
Okay, so 1 full percent. Sherry, before you go jump off of that subject, is that included in the current number that we've got?
No.
The 1%. Okay, so we actually have to see before we vote on the budget any further, take any more action on the budget, the 1% across all the payrolls.
Right, right? To see
okay.
that.
So that impact's got to be shown so we can actually see what the total value is, total impact of that value. Back to Tom, your discussion about looking at department by department, I guess the question becomes about the personnel committee and its plan for review. It's short for this year. That's certainly not going to happen before this annual town meeting. But a review of positions in town against its peers and the timetable for that. Is it the upcoming year?
We were trying to get it done.
This year.
This year.
Okay.
That was our goal.
Okay. So we got a COLA in across the board, but we're hearing that there's one in front of us that is a request and a recommendation from the personnel committee to continue further discussion.
Right.
Okay. Tom, with respect to the library, we've had a couple over the years that have been funded and moved in. We've had a couple that have been changed. It's not an uncommon tactic in the last half a dozen years with that particular group. There have been a couple that have come up by grade, by range, by etc., by request mainly.
Although I guess that begs a question, though, mechanically.
Right. What are the mechanics of
it? If the library trustees set the rates, should the personnel committee even be addressing?
Still going to make a recommendation to.
Make a recommendation. Yep. I'm just thinking, because it's a little different than for town employee X, as compared to a library employee.
Well, trustees, again,
the rate setting.
Right. Do that hiring, do some of that review, but remember, we're still the appropriating and approval body.
Right.
So. Interesting. Hmm. So this is a continued work in progress right here, right?
Yes.
We have to get the percentages across the board for all the COLAs. Are there any other areas in the budget, Cherry, that are that are needing updating at this point?
I have the police department, a few that Brendan is working on.
And I saw on police as well a new line that we're going to consolidate.
Right, and he's going to give me the updates for that.
So the new line, if you look at the new line, for some reason, and I have some resistance about having a line in the general budget that simply says shift differential new. Only in that it's a new line. It's always been in the payroll. I'd like to have that shift differential new for whatever tracking time reasons that is at the department when they do submittals for their weekly payrolls or bi-monthly payrolls. That's not necessarily a line item for the budget. I'd like to have that line removed and incorporated back in wages as they had been right along. Because if you look at it new, if I look at this spreadsheet and I say, huh, there's a new $5,000 line.
It's a new breakout as opposed to
right.
A new
what
actual,
is it?
Right?
It's a new breakout. Right. It has nothing to do with the appropriation process. It has to do with time tracking.
Which is not really what this is for.
It's not what this is for. Yep. So I'd like to have that piece pulled out. Okay. Outside of that, Cherry, how's the budget process gone to this point?
Good. The 300th anniversary committee voted to recommend that $5,000 be transferred from available funds for the 300th, if it's available. So you'll see that update in the warrant as well for that article.
So there's a value here?
Free cash, pending your approval.
So which of the articles here are we talking about? We're jumping back to the warrant here, but okay. Article 13 is I have on a number right here.
Yep.
Right? So Tom, the value, we can come back to that in just a second. Right? The value, I know. The value here was 5,000, Cherry.
Right.
We've got a motion to include and recommend. So we're actually done with that part. So the numbers are in. Okay. So budget piece. That's not necessarily associated with the actual budget. We have a grand total to date operating budget, $7,209,960, a total increase of $114,237. Now we have, this is minus the COLAs, right? Okay. So COLAs have to go in. With respect to the recommendation from the library back to the article adding $5,706, it's a prerogative of the board. Tom, you said you've expressed, you know, the fact that a survey should be global and should look at all of the wages, not an individual area or concern. Is there a reason that we'd not recommend that, we would not include that in the budget?
God, you, have to include it because that's what they're asking for. So I would say just you have to include what they're asking for. I wouldn't fund it though.
Well, I understand that's the reason the funding piece I asked about including. I was actually talking about funding it in the budget.
Yeah, you have to include it. But again, my opinion is I look. Okay, so I have five or six or seven library trustees, and they're they're looking out over the library. Well, I'm a selectman, I look out over all the town employees. Mm-hmm. I say, why are we treating, when the first department that's fully restored is the library. They got their so they got all their money back, that they had lost, and they're back on their 2.5% increases every year. Now we're going to change. So we worked at that the last couple of years, and now we go right from getting back that 2.5%. So they're one of the first.
Yep.
Well, I don't know how too many others that were.
But education's close, but not, it's, even they're still not there.
They're still not there.
That's right.
Okay, Frontier is, but not right. not the elementary
yep.
school.
Yep.
So now they got all that money that they had lost, they gained that back. Mm-hmm. Now we go 1 year later, now we're going to increase above to mm-hmm. catch up. Mm-hmm. It's like, wait a second, we have other, mm-hmm. there's other, this is a town. It's right. not just a library.
A department, yeah.
And I'm not thinking of the library, and I think if that was going to happen, that should have been here, and they should have been talking about that when they made their presentation at the beginning of the year. Mm-hmm. Not now.
Okay.
2-3 weeks before town meeting, we're going to talk about that now. Mm-hmm. Well, why, when they made their presentation, why wasn't talked about then?
Sure. Again, back to process, and honest discussion about all of the pressures all of the departments have had.
Absolutely. So I'd love to talk to the library. And again, the library trustees aren't here now defending it. You have a selectman on the personnel committee that's bringing that thing forward. I don't think it's how are you having that dialogue?
Right.
No, good point. What about our police and the chief of police and town administrators and I will say, I don't think Sherry Closure is right now. I don't think we're paying our top administrators in this town an exorbitant amount of money for what they do. And we don't have that conversation. I don't think we pay. You know, I've had people on the search committee for the police department say, "Hey, what are you paying the chief right now?" Really?
It's interesting dialogue when you're sitting on the board as opposed to sitting at the town meeting floor, isn't it?
I see what other towns are paying town administrators. I see what other towns are paying chiefs of police, highway superintendents, etc.
Mm-hmm.
And now we got the finest. And again, I'm just not being facetious or anything. We probably got the finest library in Western Mass. I come in here in the daytime, and we got car. I can follow a dozen cars from the University of Massachusetts that come by this library. This way, and they pull into the library every day. I know they don't live in Sunderland. That's beside the point, but we're very convenient. They're open. Many libraries are not open. Mm-hmm. The hours that we're open.
Sure.
I'm not complaining about that, but somebody may be able to pay somebody more per hour because they don't work as many hours.
Mm-hmm.
So if you pay someone $16 an hour and they work 3 hours, and we pay somebody $15 an hour and they work 20 hours, well, it's a big difference.
Sure.
But I can probably look at a lot of the libraries in the other towns, and not too many that work that are open 40 hours a week.
Yeah. So let's.
So I wouldn't include it because I don't think it's fair. I don't think it hasn't been presented. I don't think it's not been presented mm-hmm. to the town in a fair method.
Okay.
In my opinion.
So we're going to vote on the budget next.
I'm usually wrong.
That's usually my position. I was saying as I drove the truck and down this dark, muddy road, you know, Scott, you always make the decisions to find the most difficult way. And the truck almost got stuck. I was like, see, I told you. You should have listened to yourself. Anyway. So with respect to the budget, the omnibus budget, we're going to have a discussion next week with these final numbers plugged in, and that includes this proposal here for 5706. And again, that 5706 is new. It came before the personnel committee, and the recommendation came forward, and thank them for that. And we are going to work on this on Tuesday night. So final numbers. Okay. a little bit of fluid motion, but not much left inside the budget with expenses, a little consolidation of lines, the question about this library, and then the addition, library additional funding, and then the addition of the COLAs. It's got to go be sprinkled across the payroll. Okay. Balance and use of various accounts. There's no more discussion about the expense side of the budget. This is the paper, as I said to Sherry, that invariably everybody wants to look at town meeting. How much money is where? And what are we appropriating out of it, right? So there's a category here that's going to get X'd out under additional tax levy. That's actually capital stabilization. That's going to get moved and rolled in. So we have about $179,000 currently in capital stabilization. We're going to appropriate out of that about $103,000. All the numbers look like they're correct. So we're starting with free cash of $424,731, starting with stabilization, and then use of that. We're going to use about $1,500 for unpaid bills, use about $100,000, $103,000 for this budget, stays inside the guidelines. Going to leave $100,000-ish on the table, maybe a little north of that, and move the $103,752 to stabilization. So that'll take stabilization and move it to like $3,470 when we're done. Title V passes through. Capital stabilization starts at $179 with an appropriation proposed budget, which we'll have for next week, of $103,000. Maybe, depending on engineering, another $60,000. We're not quite sure of that. And then George's lease, we're going to figure that truck. There's two dynamic pieces about capital right now. And we may not be agile enough with the 75%. If it's date sensitive, we may have to take a further action on that. And then CPA, which has got $584 to start its appropriations, leaving $374 at the end. You got a copy of that one? Okay. Leave you that one. And this column's going to get gone.
Thank you.
So you got the figured in there. We're still lease. I mean, we had 3 years to pay off the new whacker, right?
Yes. Okay. Yep. Yep. That's all inside the appropriation. Yep. And that's current budget status. Capital budget and expense budget next week aren't articles for ramp. Excuse me. Articles for the parcels next week. And then town meeting a couple weeks thereafter. Okay. I think I have any other discussion with respect to budget, warrant, or motions?
Well, I would like to talk to, at some point, I'd like to talk to George about the plow replacement.
Mm-hmm.
I'd still.
Oh, the broken one?
I'd still like to know if we're getting the high-speed plows or because maybe we can just take the, you know, he says maybe you can just keep your normal plows, the newer plows. You don't get them with the high angle to throw off to knock stuff down.
Mm-hmm.
And you keep the other ones if you have to end up pushing banks. So I'd like to talk to him about that.
You want to talk to him at the meeting or talk to him prior to that?
We can authorize the expenditure of the plows
before
he purchases the plow. I mean, I've spent a lot of time looking at plows over the last, since George talked about it. Mm-hmm. I don't see everybody that has those big, high-angle plows thrown.
Yep.
A lot of them are the shorter plows. Yep. And again, I understand why you have them, but you don't have to use them for every storm.
Right. That's a good point.
The last storm, you didn't need to. That's and I could go in my yard and I can show that in my driveway, the snow came back. My driveway past Bob from me past Bob. That's quite a ways back.
Right, right.
For 4-inch snowstorm.
That raises a good point. The wake, as it's known, right?
Right.
Yeah.
I'm not the highway superintendent, but I also know I see other towns that don't have those types of plows.
Okay. So the actual, not the appropriation, Tom, but the actual purchase.
The actual purchase, yeah. I'd really, you know, and again, maybe you just have these plows. We can keep the plows he has now, and if he has to have them for pushing banks back, you get one of them, and you can push the banks with that, or maybe it's worthwhile hiring somebody to do pushing back the banks.
Sub it out, sure.
Yeah. I don't know. I'd just like to comp.
Okay. Easy enough. We can circle back to that. Again, not going to affect necessarily the warrant.
It doesn't affect the warrant, no. Yeah.
Okay. And I would say if there's a global comment to make about reserves and revenues, our recurring revenues this year, we're going to chew up a bunch of our capacity, absorbing, it looks like, if you look at the total budget, you know, 1.6% total growth. Unfortunately, a lot of that is retiring of debt, and our expenses that we're picking up offset that, and to a great extent, they're going to be there next year. So our recurring revenues are going to be such that there'll be pressure on, recurring expenses are such that there'll be great pressure on recurring revenues next year. So that's a really important kind of almost a mantra for the next handful of weeks as we go forward and into town meeting. Okay. I appreciate the conversation, dialogue about the warrant. Capital improvement, we got Rock appointed at large. Okay. We're closed next week, Monday. We are actually on our next meeting we scheduled for the 19th. We want to make sure the budget and the warrant, the motions are complete going forward with a couple of weeks. Again, there's a hard-pressed effort to wrap up the annual town report. The last of the reports, I think, are received today. And give Cindy a lot of credit for continuing to work on that. And annual town meeting here is the 29th of April. That's at 7 at the elementary school. And our annual election is the subsequent Saturday, May 7th. And that's 8 a.m. to 3 p.m. also at the elementary school. Okay.
Tom? How much excess levy capacity are you looking at right now?
39,000?
Yeah, about 39.
Let me get that sheet as well. I think it's in the high 30s. Ask for a copy of the Schedule A and its report back. So we'll have that electronically.
Okay.
So levy capacity, available reserve revenues, and revenues, use of free cash sheets. Those are going to be important questions to have. Any comments?
Nope. I think I'm good.
Tom, anything else, folks?
Nope.
Is there a motion to adjourn?
Motion.
Second.
Motion's made and seconded to adjourn. All those in favor?
Aye.
3.75. Call us out at 8:18, please.
Very good.